Thank you, Jan-Edward. Good afternoon. Happy to see you all. Today is to the day, 1 year since I joined VimpelCom Russia as the CEO. And I'm very proud of what we achieved in this year. I only have 20 minutes to tell you about our achievements and to what we're looking forward in the coming years. Taking a cue from what Jo was saying, the key strategic theme for us in the coming years is profitable growth. How are we going to achieve growth? By focusing on the fastest growing segment of the market, mobile data, in particular prioritizing small and medium screen. How are we going to achieve profitability? By rigorous control of costs through our operational excellence program and rigorous control of efficiency of our investments. And the foundation of our business strategy is focus on the customer, achieving superior customer experience in the market. And today I will tell you what we're going to do to deliver on these commitments. But before that, let's briefly remember what kind of market we operate in. Russia today has a mature telecom market with the mobile service penetration of about 160%. And the dynamics in the market are expected to be around 3.5% annual CAGR. The majority, approximately two-thirds of that growth, is driven by mobile data, which we expect to grow at 30% annual CAGR. In 2012, we expect the growth to be around 35% plus. In 3 years, the share of mobile data in total telecom market will double from around 7 to about 13, 14%. The next growth driver is fixed broadband, which we expect to grow at approximately 7%. The overall operating environment. Well, as you well know, we have top three players which dominate the market with about 85% combined market share and with only minor deviation between them from year to year. This year, we're seeing a much more benign competitive environment. We're seeing less competition on the prices, which is reflected in a slowing down of the decline in the voice APPM from about 14.5% in 2011 to around 12.5-13% last year. Also, we've seen a positive dynamic in ARPU. In Q3, the mobile ARPU growth in the market was around 3.3%, while we at VimpelCom in Russia delivered about 6% mobile ARPU growth in Q3. We also see that such benign environment manifested in more cooperation between large operators in the areas of infrastructure, network sharing, and we'll talk about more today. Fixed market is an important component of our revenue stream. It's about 20% of our business. In the fixed market, competition is fairly stable with about 40% of the market in the hands of state incumbent Rostelecom. I guess another aspect of the market environment we should mention is the regulatory environment. There was much talk about it today already in the Joe's presentation, and I would say that regulatory agenda is heating up in Russia after several years of relative calm. I guess one of the most important topics coming up is MNP. Earlier, we were expecting MNP introduction in Russia in first quarter of 2014, but now the new date has been announced for the 1st December of 2013, which will require investments from us, which will require even increased focus on cementing our existing subscriber base, reducing churn, but it's also a greater risk to the competition as well. The other items on the regulatory agenda include potential technical neutrality for one of the spectrum bands in LTE. There's a discussion about abolishing internal roaming charges in Russia. There are attempts for greater regulation in the SIM distribution and also in content services to mobile subscribers. How we perform against this background? Standing here today, I'm very proud to be part of the impressive operational turnaround we have seen during 2012. Some of the numbers to illustrate it. EBITDA margin in Q3 2012, 43.2%, which is the highest level since Q4 2010. Since the beginning of this year, we reversed the 11-quarter-long period of negative EBITDA dynamic, negative EBITDA margin dynamic, by delivering positive EBITDA growth and improvement in marginality quarter by quarter this year. Number of areas of costs, we managed to maintain costs flat or even down, such as S&B, G&A, and some of the most significant improvements we have seen in the reduction of commercial costs. This was, we were able to deliver those results by focusing on fastest growing segments of the market and on implementing a rigorous operational excellence program. More than a year ago, we made certain commitments to what we're going to deliver during 2012 in terms of improving various lines on the P&L. Today, we can say that we delivered and maybe even over-delivered on all of these commitments. If you look at the mobile data growth in Q3 was 38%. And for the first 9 months of the year, we have grown in mobile data faster than the market overall. This is due to our focus on small and medium screen, which are the fastest growing segments of the market, where we're delivering growth over 50%. In the large screen, referring to what Yanedov was saying earlier, we look at this segment only opportunistically, where we have excess capacity. The monetization of small and medium screen is obviously much more attractive. The price per gigabyte is about 8 times higher in a small and medium screen compared to the large screen. On service margin, if you look at the service margin for new sales, we increased it from 58% to 64%. And this is on the background of declining APPM in the market. And another area of our focus on revenue side is churn. We managed to decrease the churn from 66 to approximately 61%. And we have a comprehensive churn reduction program in place and committed to continue reducing churn going forward. On cost side, we have introduced at the beginning of the year operational excellence programs, which touches all the key processes and functions in the company, which has started as a project, but has become, in essence, a cultural mindset for the organization. Some of the examples of our significant achievements in operational excellence concern with commercial costs. We managed to reduce commercial costs, if you look at the Q3 numbers, by 20% or approximately by 8% per each SIM sold. This was done due to two initiatives. One is transitioning of our distribution to value-based revenue share model. And the second one is increased focus on contribution margin, where we look at dealer by dealer and optimizing the sales mix with towards the dealer mix to maximize contribution margin. On the technical side, we have done some groundbreaking projects in Russia. We have outsourced our network maintenance in three large regions in Russia, Volga, Far East, and the center, to give you a sense of the magnitude, the combined territory of these three regions is approximately equal to 25 Italys. And approximately 19 million subscribers are located, which is about one third of our subscriber base, are located in those regions. These programs are giving us significant cost savings, but also better way of managing our existing resources. And this is the program which we will continue into coming years. Other initiatives include optimization of our headcount. Unfortunately, our IR is not letting me give you much more details on that, but I must say I've been through quite a few headcount optimization programs. This one was one of the most ambitious, and we achieved a lot by a variety of methods we used, including disposal of some of the non-core assets, outsourcing, delayering, and norming, and outsourcing in various areas, not only technical, but also looking at the call center outsourcing and other areas. Another example is moving some of the corporate shared services outside of Moscow to an area with a low rental and low labor costs. So this has been achieved during 2012, but I believe what we have achieved during 2012 is a sustainable turnaround, the emphasis on sustainable, and we believe we can continue these initiatives into coming years. This is a slide which showed to us earlier, the four pillars of our value agenda with the aim of achieving profitable growth, relying on operational excellence, capital efficiency, and I believe customer excellence being the foundation of this strategy. Let me walk you through these main pillars. We'll start with the customer excellence. At the beginning of last year, we set ourselves what I believe is a very ambitious goal of gaining leadership in customer experience as a long-term goal, measured by NPS, measured by TRIM. And it wasn't an easy task for us, given that today we actually behind most of the competition in many of these metrics, such as NPS and TRIM. This is due to a period of underinvestment to the network and other areas of our business, which we now have to, within a year, year and a half, to quickly close the gap and achieve parity. What was important, what was one of my goals last year, is to create a customer-focused organization, to create a culture mindset focusing on the customer excellence. We have developed a comprehensive program of improving customer experience. This month we'll be announcing an appointment of Chief Customer Officer, who will be a direct report to CEO. We have developed a set of KPIs related to customer experience, which are spread through the organization. And one of the key elements was the engagement of employees of the whole company for these goals. We've done a lot of research trying to identify what are the pain points, what are today's dissatisfaction points for our customers, and we developed programs to address these points. Not surprisingly, network, which is our main product, is being identified as one of the key pain points which we have to urgently address. We've done already a lot during 2012. We, for example, increased the number of our 3G node Bs by about 20%. We significantly increased the percentage of our backhaul on IP protocol from a very modest 10% at the beginning of 2012 to about 40% at the end of the year. But we're setting even more ambitious goals for the next year, year and a half. This is the window we have to close the gap in an efficient way to achieve parity with our competition, at least in the key regions of our presence. What do we want to do? We are going to increase the number of 3G node bees by 30%. In some of the areas, the goals are even more ambitious. For example, in Moscow, which is our most important market, with about 35% of total revenue, we're going almost double the number of node bees. We're going to double the percentage of IPization from 40% today to about 80% towards the end of this year. And we're going to continue to invest significantly into our transport network with the aim of growing the length of our transport network by about 45%. Obviously, when we have such ambitious network development goals, your concern and our concern is on the efficiency of this investment. How do we deploy this investment in an efficient way? And there are at least a couple of tools which I want to indicate to you. One is the regional cluster approach. In essence, we divided all of the regions of our presence, and we have 83 branches across Russia, into five clusters. The first cluster is strategic branches, nine strategic branches, including Moscow, including St. Petersburg, the central region, which combined have about 60% of total revenue. And then four more clusters, including leading donors, light donors, small and potential regions. And our investments are prioritized to maximize the return on investment into the network. And then within the region, within the branch, we use customer experience as one of the methods of pinpointing problem areas in our network. We're monitoring closely the customer experience through various tools, including multiple quality agents, including NPS measurements, including the technical data we receive from the base stations, and we're addressing specific bottlenecks in our network. Also, a lot of emphasis is put on network optimization, where with the minimum investments, we can actually achieve a lot by opening existing bottlenecks. Two other areas of customer experience which we will be focusing on, which we also currently consider as the areas where we need to improve. One is related to distribution, the other is pricing. Why distribution is important? In 2012, approximately 90 million SIMs were sold in Russia, with average churn for the market in excess of 50%. Therefore, the retail experience is extremely important for subscribers in Russia, because a lot of our customers have to go through the retail experience during the year. One of our focuses in this year is boosting our monobrand retail footprint. This is one of the areas where we lag behind competition. We've done quite a few things in 2012, starting from very modest 200 retail outlets, which is 10 to 15 times smaller than the self-owned monobrand of our competition. We already doubled it by the end of 2012. And we want to bring it up to approximately 1,000 monobrand outlets by the end of this year. It's still going to be less than competition, but we do not necessarily believe that we have to match up the competition store per store at least within the next 12 months, at least for two reasons. One, we believe that the number of SIMs sold in the market will continue to decline. For example, in 2012, the decline was in the range of 8 to 9%. In our case, the decline in SIM sold was about 20%. And despite that, as you know, we increased the profitability, we increased the contribution margin by achieving higher quality of sales. And going forward, we believe that SIM sales will also continue to decline. Therefore, the role of the retail network for SIM sales will be declining. Secondly, we believe that there are many untapped opportunities in online channels and self-service channels. One of the, probably at least half of the reasons why customers are going to retail stores today is actually to get some basic service operations, to get the balance on their account, to change SIM, to change a tariff plan. A lot of these services, they can do themselves with the self-service application. Unfortunately, until recently, VimpelCom in Russia lacked quality self-service application, but this is now being addressed. We've been working for most of last year on bringing to the market the best-in-class self-service application and self-service online experience, which will be released in the first quarter. And we believe that will take up a lot of load from our retail network. Also, an important component of our distribution model is the strongest player, independent player in Russian distribution, Eurosets. You follow the news closely, you know that we have recently increased our share in Eurosets, which gives us a much stronger corporate governance position in Eurosets. Before that, we had a very limited ability to influence Eurosets as a business. Also, Eurosets for most of 2012 remained the last segment of distribution which did not have a revenue share model. From January 1, we transitioned Eurosets to revenue share model, which we believe will bring the same efficiency which we have seen in the rest of the distribution after we introduced revenue share, reduced commission level, improved lifetime value, improved and growing contribution margin. Develop superior pricing capability, another area which obviously customers often mention as area of dissatisfaction. What we're doing there, often customers are confused with and overwhelmed with various tariff plans, price points, etc. What we've done during this year, we streamlined and simplified our tariff portfolio. We have 5 key tariff plans across the Russia, which we support with our communication campaigns. The focus in those in this tariff portfolio is on bundles. Now we sell about 7% in all new sales, bundle sales. We started selling bundles basically at the end of 2011, beginning 2012. The number of subs on bundles now increased 10 times over the past 12 months. Another priority tariff plan for us is on-net. On-net plans helps to cement the subscriber base, to increase loyalty, which is particularly important given the upcoming MNP. And today, about 20% of our new sales are on net, and on net tariff plans, and about 25% of existing customer base is currently on net tariff plans. Going forward, we're going to introduce next generation smart pricing, which differentiate by speed, by volume, by network availability. The bundles will start including content components. Some of these price innovations, which Jan Edward was talking about earlier, this is all coming on stream for us in the second half of the year. Profitable growth, driving mobile data. We talked a lot about it today. And how we're going to achieve it. The boosted retail footprint is one of the ways of how we're going to drive the smartphone penetration. Today, the smartphone penetration in our customer base is about 15%, which is a little bit lower than the average for the Russian market. So it's important for us to catch up in a smartphone penetration, and we believe that monobrand is an important way for us to drive smartphone penetration. Also, we are now becoming the only exclusive operator partner of Apple in Russia. For us, Apple iPhones is the majority of device sales, and with improved retail footprint, we aim to capitalize even better on that. Obviously, LTE is coming. You know that we won a range of frequencies at the beauty contest last year. So we're starting cautiously investing in LTE. The first market where we're going to deploy this technology will be Moscow, which is our largest market in Russia with the most demanding customers. But also, there are at least 6 more territories where we will have to deploy to fulfill license obligations and to experiment with this technology in different markets. Most of our discussion today was about growing in the core of our business, which for years will remain the largest driver and the largest revenue contributor. However, there are areas beyond the core which today maybe account for less than 1% of revenue, but demonstrating exponential growth. And within 3 to 5 years, we believe we'll start making significant contribution to both top line and bottom line, but also very importantly, they enrich customer experience, they diversify our offering which we are bringing to the market. The two examples of the areas where we focus on is mobile financial services and OTT partnerships. In MFS, we have a joint venture with one of Russia's strongest banks, Alpha Bank. We now have about 1.5 million customers. The growth in the revenue last year in MFS for us was 240%. We aim to double the number of customers during 2013, and we are going to expand beyond remote payments, which is our core product today in MFS, towards proximity payments, ticketing, transport, and towards microloans. In OTT, we have examples of cooperation with global leaders in these segments. We recently announced a partnership with Google Play, where we're going to offer operator billing for Google Play App Store purchases for customers in Russia. And earlier last year, we have announced a partnership with Facebook, where we offer free zones, zero zones access to the main pages of Facebook. And also, interestingly, we have conducted a television ad campaign jointly with Facebook, which was the first ever joint television campaign for Facebook globally. Operational excellence, as I said earlier, today is no longer a project. It's a mindset of the organization, and we will continue with all of the initiatives which we have developed during 2012. And the result of 2012 initiatives, you may remember that more than a year ago, we announced an ambition of achieving 5 billion rubles in terms of operational excellence target. Today, we can say that we will at least double this number for 2012. And we have similar ambitions going forward. Capital efficiency, network sharing efficiency project, we touched upon it today with ambitious investment plans, which we have for the coming year or two, necessary to close some of the key gaps, in particular network gaps. We have to be very careful, very smart in the way we deploy our capital. I talked about some of the tools we're going to approach. There are many opportunities in network sharing. For example, today about 20% of our passive run, our base stations, is already on a shared basis with other partners. During 2012, we launched 40% of new base stations were also done on a shared basis. 95% of our transport network projects are done on a shared basis. And our ambition is to increase the percentage of infrastructure sharing with other operators. One of the ideas we're actively discussing is a joint tower company. And I think LTE is giving another stimulus to operators to discuss various opportunities for infrastructure in LTE, including spectrum sharing, active sharing, and even potentially joint infrastructure companies. To summarize, we have achieved a sustainable operational turnaround in Russia, and our goal is to continue with the kind of progress we have seen during 2012. It is paramount for us to catch up in network quality, in particular in 3G product, in the key areas for us during 2013, maybe a bit of 2014. We are focusing on optimizing distribution by enhancing our own retail footprint and by further improving our commercial arrangements with independent distribution. Clearly, mobile data remains our focus, with priority given to small screen and medium screen. And the overall objective is profitable growth, where we're not going to buy market share for the sake of it. We're going to focus on profitability, which will eventually lead to creating and maximizing value for us in Russia. Thank you.
Thank you, Anton. We have a bit of time now to ask questions to Anton. There is will be two microphones. Can you raise your hand? But please state your name and company before you ask the question. Here on the front row, Caesar.
Thank you. Hi, this is Caesar Tyrone from Morgan Stanley. I have two questions, actually. You mentioned you wish to step up the CapEx rollout in 2013. Can you say if you're going to spend more CapEx in 2013 compared to 2012? That's the first question. And when you talked about all these efficiencies you've achieved in Russia, have we seen most of this already into the numbers in 2012? Or are we going to see this in 2013?
Well, I don't think Gerbrand will let me answer the first question in detail. Forward-looking comments and projections related to financials.
It's clear that next year will be higher than this year.
Yeah, but you clearly, from some of the things I said, the ambitions on node B construction, the ambitions on IPization in the network, the focus on strategic branches, the need to close the accumulated gap, and we estimate that the gap with competition is probably close to $2.5 billion accumulated over the last 3-4 years in terms of underinvestment to the network. The good news is today we can close this gap with a lot less investment. The prices are coming down. We have a new global sort of procurement leverage opportunities Jan Edward was talking about, so we can buy a lot of equipment cheaper. There's much more network sharing between operators. We have, with the regional cluster approach, with the customer perception-driven approach, we have a way of pinpointing the areas of investments more accurately. With the operational excellence program in place, with the network outsourcing opportunities we have, all of this gives us an opportunity to close the gap with less investment. But as Gerbrand mentioned, the overall amount of CapEx next in 2013 this year will be higher than in 2012. And your second question was about to what extent the operational excellence efficiency already. Well, to start, we reported only for 9 months, so we will see what the results for 12 months. But as I said, many of these operational excellence initiatives will continue and will generate comparable numbers, comparable results going into 2013. And on top of it, there are new initiatives which we are generating to even increase the results of what we've seen in 2012.
Next question, there was one here. Okay. Janet, can you go to here? Dalibor? You after that, GP.
Thank you. This is Dalibor Vavrushka from Citi. If I can ask, Anton, you outlined the revenue forecast for the Russian market. I just want to check, that's nominal terms, local currency.
This is nominal terms, yeah, you're right. In real terms, you will see basically negative trends for the overall market, but you will continue to see positive growth for at least the data product.
So I just wanted to check, I mean, you're talking about profitable growth, it's basically profitable decline, right, if we talk about the numbers?
No, I believe the numbers which Joe was referring to were numbers in dollars. And therefore, in dollar terms, that will be a profitable growth. One example is if you take Q3 numbers, our revenue growth was about 7%, but EBITDA growth was more than 13%, so almost double the revenue growth. So in terms of profitability improvement, we aim to deliver real profitability improvement.
It's just that you seem to be little bit more cautious compared to your main competitors in Russia, I think, on this. So this is one point. And the other point, which is actually
in terms of market forecast,
I think.
Well, our market forecast, in essence, it's based on the consensus forecast of the analysts with some of our own skew in terms of what we see happening.
And my real, the essence of the question is that now you have the three operators listed, so they're all making statements about their strategy center, which is good for us. We can better understand what actually people are thinking. And I found one discrepancy between your two main competitors, I think, with Megaphone focusing much more on building this ecosystem and thinking that this is actually crucial for the mobile operator to actually own the applications and develop some local applications, whereas I think MTS is so far more focused on one type of application, which is finance. But apart from that, they want to focus on data. So I'm just wanting to see from your perspective whether you see that strategic options polarize this way, and which side are you?
I don't think there's much discrepancy in this respect. All three operators are looking at RCS type solutions, rich communication suite, and we're probably going to develop a joint product based on a similar platform. Yes, we did mention our inroads into mobile financial services and OTT cooperation because we believe these are the most attractive opportunities currently in the market. But similarly to what Italy did recently with Wind Digital, we are envisaging creating a special purpose vehicle focusing on, in essence, new growth opportunities in the market, which are usually called digital opportunities. So there will be an increased emphasis on this area as well. In terms of magnitude of numbers, these are still tiny, the whole MFS initiative, et cetera, for us, it's all less than 1%. But I think what's key is the growth. Yeah, when you talk about 200% growth, this is where it is, the attractiveness lies. Yeah.
Okay, next question. There was in the front row here, Patricia.
Good afternoon, JP Davids from Barclays. The first question, there's a top-down focus on sweating the assets. Mm-hmm. How does that align or how does that balance with the customer experience, which is also one of your goals? They're not a bit of give and take here. Sweat the assets and give up a bit of customer excellence. And then the second one is just maybe you can comment on your experience of outsourcing your network, particularly when you've gone the whole hog and outsourced the entire network. Specifically what the customer quality is like, and specifically what the cost savings have been from those. Thank you.
On the first question, I don't believe there's any conflict in those goals. I think there's a way of exploiting assets more efficiently. That's what our operational excellence program allows us to do. On the other hand, to grow the customer base, to retain a higher pool customer base, to focus our customer base towards data product, to increase the loyalty and therefore to reduce commercial costs, the striving for superiority in customer experience, we believe, is the key in achieving it. So we think this could be complementary targets. And the question on network outsource. We didn't outsource the whole network. It's at the moment it's three regions, large macro regions out of eight. We do intend to outsource probably two, three more regions. I would say that it took a lot of preparation. In essence, the first outsource program took probably 6 to 8 months of rigorous negotiations. We also staged, and obviously tendering, we also staged these outsourcing programs with about sort of 4 to 6 months between the next one, being able to draw on the lessons and make adjustments to the next ones, to the next program. But overall, our experience was positive. Some of the areas where we had most of the problems are with B2B customers, which require more customized approach. But for the mass market the experience was overwhelmingly positive. I believe we do not comment on the exact amount of savings, but I think, at least in some past presentations, I remember referring that the international experiences show that 20 to 25% annual cost savings are normally achieved in the circumstances, and obviously in Russia we were aiming for at least as much as ambitious goals